You will find several new design features in Chief Architect X13 to help improve your productivity. Let's begin with our cabinet features. For framed cabinets, you can add extended styles for the left or right side. Extended styles will automatically clip as the cabinet is bumped towards walls or other cabinets. The extended styles will show in the cabinet's nomenclature and be listed in both schedules and material lists. Cabinets with clipped corners will accurately show the cabinet box in plan view. For full overlay cabinets, you can control the reveal for the right and left sides. This cabinet has a 1/16 of an inch reveal for all sides. In situations where you need to adjust the reveal distance on one of the sides, you can select the side and then specify the reveal amount. For cabinets with traditional overlay styles, you can specify a face item overlap for the sides, the top, and the bottom. These settings are located for face items using the Appliance, Door, Drawer, Specify option. For those situations where you need to adjust the face item reveal distance, this feature can help. When a cabinet is bumped to an appliance or partition, the countertop overhang will automatically clip flush on that side just as if it were bumped to an existing cabinet or a wall. There is a new category for a cabinet's top and bottom. For situations where you want to remove either the top or the bottom of a cabinet, you can use this setting for added control. This coffee station wall cabinet has the bottom removed to expose the countertop below. Auto door face items can change from a single to a double door when they reach a width threshold. You can specify this width in the cabinet default settings. You can now dimension to your cabinet faces and openings. Learn more about that feature in the Drafting and Project Management section. For cabinets or architectural blocks, you can prevent the room molding from being automatically removed. For this vanity cabinet, I can remove the option in the dialog to suppress the room moldings. For cabinet moldings, there is an offset to make them flush with the face items. This offset allows for moldings to be flushed with both the cabinet box and cabinet doors. Moldings you assign to cabinets, rooms, or other objects have a profile rotation for any angle, reflect horizontally, or reflect vertically for refined control of molding positioning. A new molding type has been added to help identify the molding in the materials list or molding schedule. CAD shapes drawn in elevation views can be converted to a backsplash. Once it is converted to a backsplash, you will have access to all of the properties to further define the backsplash, such as the material layers. Grid and herringbone patterns are now parametric. In this example, I can change the grid offset pattern to be 1/3. For herringbone, you can change both the width and height for the pattern. From the Adjust Material dialog, materials can be saved directly to the library to help streamline material management. And when using the Material Eyedropper tool, there is a Make Copy tool to quickly replicate materials. Scoping has been added to the Adjust Material Definition tool. With scoping, you can choose to adjust materials by component, object, room, floor, or plan. For each scoping mode, with the exception of by plan, the program will prompt you to make a copy of the material or to edit the specific material source. The idea here is to make adjusting materials easier. When you have specific needs, like changing the direction on one part of the shower tile, you can use the Adjust Material Definition tool with the scoping on component, make a copy of the tile, adjust the material as needed, and you have quickly made your targeted adjustment. There are several great new features in Chief Architect X13, and you can expect to see it this summer. And remember, all new software purchases include a year of support and software assurance. So, if you're not currently a customer, get started today with Chief Architect.